Before royal historian Robert Lacey started his book about Princes William and Harry, he didn't believe the rumours of a feud between the two brothers.
But after speaking to dozens of people who know them well, he now claims the rift is even more serious than we thought.
And Robert Lacey, author of Battle of Brothers, joins us now. Well, Robert Lacey, been a big fan of your royal books for many years. You're certainly in the category of genuinely well-informed expert. And it seems like you were a bit surprised yourself to discover that the narrative of these two brothers who'd been so joined together, now being at war, was actually broadly true.
Yes, it's tragic. Sorry, Piers, I'm actually rather moved by what you were just being looking at and feeling, you know, that the country is in such need of leadership.
Yeah.
That it's very tragic that our royal family seems to be split. You know, we have this system in this country of the government on one side. That's lost respect. It's divided. And so we look to our royal figurehead. A lot of people haven't got time for the royal family, I know, but their function is to set an example. And I think this is not the answer to your question, but when you look at those scenes, you feel, shouldn't the royal family be giving more leadership? And in particular, why are these two brothers so deeply split on opposite sides?
Just to interject there, because it's such an important point you make, and I, you know, remember early on in the lockdown when the Queen did do her national address and millions of people watched it, and the fact that the Queen is such a steadying hand when it comes to the moments when she does take that time to speak and to address the nation. But you're right, lower down, the turmoil that's going on between these two brothers is very disruptive. Is it something that started with Meghan marrying Harry and finding that she was very unhappy within the royal family, or did it begin before that?
No, it went way back, and that's what the book's about. I mean, I quite agree with you, Susanna. I mean, that was a World War II moment, wasn't it, when the Queen spoke? It was no surprise. Her picture was put up so long there in Piccadilly Circus to keep everybody inspired. She can't do that again. And it would be nice, for example, at this moment, not to have brothers who were quarrelling, but even if they have differences of opinion, to be coming back together. And to answer your question, Susanna, yes, it goes right back to the beginning. They both, it's chickens coming home to roost from all the trouble of the 80s and the 90s. These young boys are the product of that marital turmoil, and they took two opposite lessons from it. William took the lesson of duty. As he went through these difficult times, the prospect that he was going to be king was an inspiration for him, a strength for him, to the degree, for example, that when he fell in love, he politely asked his girlfriend to wait 9 or 10 years before they got married to make sure that she would be good for the job. That's his priority, and they have created a wonderful figurehead for the future. We're not quite sure what we feel about King Charles III or Queen Camilla, but we do look forward to William and Kate. Now, Harry took the opposite conclusion from the turmoil of his parents' loveless arranged marriage, that he was going to go for love. And so we're looking at a clash between these eternal principles of love versus duty.
Robert, let me just jump in there. I don't think there's any doubt that William, for example, has a great love for his wife. I mean, it seems to me that the catalyst for the real friction that we saw between Harry and Meghan and the royal family, it was obviously all boiling. It's fascinating how you paint that picture in the book. But actually, it seems to have come down to this moment when William is concerned at the speed of the relationship with Harry and Meghan. And he gets Earl Spencer, his mother's brother, to sort of intervene and have a word with Harry. And all hell breaks loose. And Harry then feels that side of the family are trying to tell him how to lead his life, tell him what woman to love and so on. And from that moment on, Harry and Meghan are on this unstoppable sort of train out of there, which is what's happened.
Yes, and of course, as you've often remarked, Piers, Meghan has crystallised in Harry his unhappiness at his role model, you know, the party prince. Again, it's something I look at in the book, going back to their teenage years in Highgrove. Prince Charles, because he was away so much, let them convert the bomb shelter in the bottom of the house to a sort of discotheque called Club H. That's where Harry first got his name as a party prince. But who set the place up? It was his elder brother. And Harry was, I'm not making excuses for him, but he was thrown into this wild set. And when we, the public and the press, looked at it, who was the king of the castle always? It was William. Who was the dirty rascal? It was Harry. He resented that, and it came out with Meghan. Meghan enabled him to voice these dissatisfactions. But of course, Meghan's a massive problem for the royal family. It's easy to be wise after the event. But here's a self-made woman, whatever you think of how she made her reputation. A TV actress, a self-made millionaireess, the only one in the royal family who's made her own money, the only one actually who's created her own celebrity and not inherited it. Bringing her into the family was an enormous challenge, and William was actually quite right. And so was Charles Spencer to say to Harry, look, this is a big problem. Not a big problem, but this is a challenge you're bringing into the family. How's it going to work? And with wisdom after the event, one has to say not enough preparations were made. Frankly, she wasn't made to feel important enough. And they are now where they want to be.
Well, the truth is, of course, in the succession line, she's not that important, and nor's Harry, because he's number seven now on the cab rank, and it would take an awful lot to get Harry anywhere near a position of being king. It's a riveting book, Battle of Brothers. Robert, as always, the research is amazing. You're so plugged into these guys. It's going to be fascinating to see how it all plays out. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you very much, Piers. Thank you.
Lovely to talk to you, Robert Lacey. Thanks very much indeed.